Well, I'll be interested to get your opinion on this new feature, stale value formatting. This just arrived today to my insider's beta. I know they're rolling it out slowly. And what I have here is I have a nice little spreadsheet with some input cells over here on the left-hand side and then formulas to the right, formulas out here in the total. And under calculation options, I'm gonna switch to manual and toggle on this brand new feature called format stale values. See, the idea is you have a large spreadsheet, you're working in manual calculation mode, and it reminds you that some items have not been recalculated. So here I'll change ed from 460 to 900. I'll press enter, and you see that they mark all of these in strikethrough and this cell down here in strikethrough to say that they are not currently correct values. If you select one of these, the little on-grid UI says that it's a stale value, and you can either calculate now or switch to automatic calculation. You could also turn it off. I'm not sure that that is a good option, so calculate now, and everything comes back. Question number one, what if we don't want it to be strike through? Too bad. That's what it is right now. You know, it's a version one feature. If there's a lot of hue and cry, maybe Microsoft will give us some way to customize that. But for now, it's strike through. And yes, I use strike through a lot. Control 5 is one of my most used shortcuts. So do I like the fact that it's strike through? No. Do I wish it was a different color strike through? Yes. Just give me some way to customize it. But I get it. You know, right now they're just trying to roll it out. And that's good. Okay, now here's the thing that is a little mysterious to me and I don't quite understand about stale values, I guess. So I'm just gonna create a new item here for Jake and we'll put in a value of 300 or something like that. And the autocomplete is gonna kick in here. It's gonna fill in those formulas. But what I don't quite understand is these numbers are all actually correct. Like when it filled those in, it didn't just copy the values from here down. So why is this being marked as stale? Because they're the correct numbers. I'll press F9 and see nothing changed in this row, right? Those were all correct. And even here, let's do the auto sum. So Alt equals, when I press enter, that number is the correct number, you know, but it still gets crossed out, which is strange to me. That doesn't seem like it should be a stale value. It was just calculated. So I don't know if that's a bug or if that's by design. We'll have to check with the Excel team to see if, you know, what they expected that to be. You know, I get it. Here, let's put in 100 here and then a simple little formula plus 1 plus 10 plus the number to the left of us. I get it when I copy this across, those are all going to be 110. And yes, those are all stale values. But that first one shouldn't be stale. It was just calculated as I entered the formula. So not quite sure the actual reasoning there. And by the way, it is possible to have stale value formatting show up in automatic. Let's switch to another workbook. Okay, I've switched to another workbook. This one has a lot of formulas and I've switched back to automatic mode. Format stale values is still on. So here I have some RAM between at the top. And when I press F9, those are going to recalculate, of course, and then millions of formulas have to recalculate. You can see the progress down here in the bottom. I'm going to interrupt the recalc with the escape key. So I press F9 and it's calculating up to 1831. I press escape. And even though I'm in automatic mode, I still get the stale value markers just to let me know that, you know, that I was impatient and stopped the recalculation. Although eventually it does recalc in the background and the stale markers go away. So just be aware that even if you never go into manual calculation mode, it's still possible to have this format stale values show up. I had an old coworker 25 years ago who got stung by this one time, stopped a long calculation and then didn't realize that it never finished calculating. So stale values would have helped in that case. All right, let me know what you think down in the YouTube comments below. I want to thank Joe and the whole Excel team for giving us this great new feature. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.